Hello everyone and welcome to the next character maximum, and it's time to love D.Va as we go over her quite frankly ridiculous capability. She's not crossing the finish line first, no, she's nuking the competition and going home to stream with a brain that can process information 30 times faster than practically everyone else on the planet. Let's do this thing. So, I firmly believe that a good defense is, of course, a good defense. So let's start with her defensive matrix. And I don't mean to be defensive about this, but it is arguably the best defensive option in the game. And if you disagree, well then your position just isn't defensible. It can completely absorb an entirety of a beautiful Reinhardt beam. And no matter what we did, and whether it was absorbing 9 Bastions full autoing at once, we couldn't get anywhere near to any sort of cap. So, yeah, D.Va's defense matrix can absorb an infinite amount of damage in its use. And the most damage that we could absorb in a single full use was about 10,000, which is a pretty hefty amount. But the most impressive thing about defense matrix is its length and girth, because it is impressive. And certainly more impressive than the construction of this mech, because whoever designed the heads-up display is a moron, because it's just wrong. It can go 2 tracer blinks forward, which is 14 meters and 4 meters longer than the actual in-game mech display tells you it goes. So that's just confusing to begin with. And then when we talk about its width, it can be about 6.5 meters. And the interesting thing is, it doesn't actually have a widening or thinning, that's a word now, effect. It is just a rectangle projected out of D.Va, and it will block everything in that rectangle. It's not actually a sloping kind of cone shape coming out of her. It will block the same width point blank as it will at max range. So think about that next time you're using it here. Time for a fun fact. I've worked out just how good of a pro gamer D.Va is. When she uses defense matrix, she says, time to raise my APM, standing for actions per minute. Pro StarCraft 2 players, of which she is one, have an action per minute record of about 400 to 500. That's a lot of things to think about and execute in a minute. That's impressive. However, D.Va seems to be manually shooting down every projectile that enters her field. This is surmised from her saying, raising APM, and her pressing furiously on her joysticks while she is executing it. So if we take 9 Bastions that are shooting 270 rounds a second, scale that up to APM, we get 16,200, which makes D.Va's brain better at processing information than the first computers. Yeah! Not bad. Let's move on. Oh yes, and it is completely possible and viable to completely surround someone with your defense matrix, thereby making them completely and utterly ineffectual, especially so on Reaper, just because you know it's just gonna frustrate him, right? I mean, it's just gotta. And, you know, on top of that, Reaper ult looks absolutely amazing when surrounded by a D.Va. We can also use Reaper ult to get a really nice representation of the range. Even though the End Reaper is being caught by the defense matrix, the half of him that isn't is still doing damage just fine, but at a much reduced rate. You can see this very nicely with the gradient of time taken for each tracer in the line that is slightly further away to die. So there you go, that's the ins and outs of your defense matrix. Moving on to the actual ulti then, because after all, it is a freaking mini nuke. And it is just fantastic. So, D.Va actually has a really cool, unique way that she's come up with to infiltrate Eichenwald and storm the gates. We'll be right back. actual damage this thing does is quite beastly. It's 1,000 point blank, which means you need something like an ulted Winston to take it with 5 health remaining, or an Ana boosted Reinhardt. And talking of boosting, charging with the D.Va mech gives you quite the leg up if you do happen to survive the explosion. Not that you could probably use that creatively in a game, but you know, better to know than not know, arguably. And moving on rapidly, the damage fall off on this thing is quite really harsh. We have ourselves a simply stunning line of simians standing storedly ready to be blown up beautifully, and they do indeed get just that, and all of them survive. But the thing to note is the front one takes 995 damage and the back one 23. This line also represents the exactly accurate range a D.Va ult can affect you from, so if you are right on the edge, you're basically going to get tickled. I mean, probably still irradiated, but at least for the immediate future, you're not gonna die. Though, if we have everybody's favorite anti-D.Va wall, which is the Reinhardt shield, and see how it holds up against 6 D.Va ulties, and surprisingly, D.Va can make it a lot deeper into Reinhardt than we would have given her credit for, with only 2 left standing. Now, this is likely due to a little bit of overlap of the damage, because each shield should take 2 nukes, 1,000 damage per, 2,000 health on the shield, but it's very neat to see in practice, as is this pentagram of Reinhardts who were now immediately regretting their decision to summon an exploding mech into the world as they all fall over. I did hypothesize that if all the instances of damage were at the same time, then it would only count for 1 hit and the shields would absorb them, but you need absolutely perfect timing to test that out, and really, humans be human. So while that may not blow you away, this certainly will. The knockback on D.Va's equipment is ridiculous. The explosion itself is the best knockback in the game, on balance, if you take into account both height and the distance that you can send someone. Although her mech call-in is really no slouch either, with a tracer blink of distance, as opposed to the double tracer blink from the ulti. Then we have ourselves the actual shift, which is a little bit less than 1 blink, and just nowhere near as impressive. Curiously, if you face away from the person you want to knock back and call in your mech, they will travel further. So, yay. I no explanation for that one. And then, of course, we need to turn things up to 11, or I guess 6 in this case, and blow a pack of Reinhardts away with all of the nukes. This causes a Reinhardt to fly at the castle wall he calls home at least 60 meters per second, and it is kind of insane to see. However, if we have it so that you actually start underneath the Reinhardts and try and push them upwards, then they get even more ridiculous height, but a lot less distance. You can actually kind of aim this a little bit. And can we just talk about this poor, poor D.Va? Like, that is... Ooh. Yeah. And then just a few little interesting tidbits to do with the mech. If you do get knocked back by someone else and then use your ulti, you will travel with the ulti at the speed that you got knocked back. So 6 Farahs can send the exploding mech absolutely insanely far away. It is just ridiculous. And also, it is possible to die before you've even ejected and are in control of your characters. As this perfectly lovely and innocent video, 6 Reinhardts, 1 D.Va, can show you. Let's talk speed then, because really, she's not bad at that. If we have a look at her flying speed, it's just shy of a Reinhardt charge, putting it at about 12 meters per second, and easily outclassing anyone who's just walking. Her mech will travel at that speed whether you are in it or not as well, and the ulti will only ever go the length of 1 boost, no matter when you decide to eject from it, so you've got that to take into account. While boosting D.Va Silver actually comes in at sort of the top 7 or so fastest characters, but a lot of them do simply still outclass her. But the actual aerial mobility and quick burst movement that you can get from D.Va is kind of unrivaled. And then we get ourselves 2 damage numbers. Oh, the old reliable. And actually, she's pretty good. And yes, this is indeed nerf D.Va on the PTR. Probably should have mentioned that a while ago, but hey-o! We have ourselves 2 seconds to kill a full health Roadhog from point blank, giving her 300 DPS. Her out-of-mech pistol, however, comes in at 4.5 seconds, or 186. So if we take this to medium range, then her guns become pathetic, going from 300 to 60 DPS, taking over 10 seconds to kill the Roadhog. Whereas out of suit, it remains exactly the same, because there's no accuracy or damage falloff. So bear that in mind when you are using her. Her zero suit is very, very effective. And then finally, we have an example of why D.Va, even with the armor nerf, is the hardest to kill character in the game from just kind of raw damage output like a Bastion. Including her defense matrix and her raw health amount and eject time, you can survive longer than a Reinhardt who's using his entire shield health to survive a Bastion, so that's pretty neat. Finally, I keep lying to you, but this really is the final. Finally, we have the maximum amount of kills in a play of the game on her, and she's kinda bad at this, actually. The most we can get to is at 10, which is just... it's not wonderful. It's not wonderful at all. But yeah, there we have it. And with that all said and done, it's time for our D.Va field test. I had a lot of fun with this one, guys, and I hope you do too.
Come pose with me in front of the green screen.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, we can be... You're soldier! You are not a kawaii Korean girl, Benno.
Kawaii Koreans.
You are not. Yeah. Stop.
I can be an animus like this.
All right, get ready.
All right,
get ready.
Ready?
Oh,
go.
Oh, take them! Take them now! Yes!
The D.Va in position.
The pro strats coming out from Dino here. Oh my god.
So happy that worked.
The Korean rear offensive was a success. Incidentally, that's also the name of North Korea's battle plan.
Yeah.
I can agree with that.
Jesus.
Now we just need to do that in our competitive matches.
Yeah, I'm sure that'll really work out.
Yeah, let's all go D.Va in our competitive matches.
All D.Va. Yeah.
Oh my god. Oh my god. No. Is this
fine? I got you, mate. I don't got you.
I got you, babe.
I got myself.
All right.
No, that's
so lonely.
That's my life.
Hey, <I'm from> that's so sad. Baby, don't hurt me. No more.
Delusion. Some point. Get on point.
Was that singing or not? I can't tell.
It was a bit of both.
It was a bit of both. I call it tinging.
Guys, do you want some points?
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh. What are you gonna do, Reinhardt? Oh!
Fuck this shit!
How did that not kill bitches? Venno, you what? Why did mine not work?
I kept one of them in your explosion. That was actually really cool. Oh, hi, Reinhardt.
I am really kind of tilted right now. And not just because I'm tilted on the ground. It turns out, guys, an army of one of the best characters right now is pretty good.
Why?
Then again, this is nerf D.Va, so maybe we should not let anyone see this.
Quote unquote nerf.
Well, I mean, it's 200 less armor is a big deal.
It's big deal depending on the enemy.
Yeah. All right, Shred.
Good all, you saved
We're not
my
all
life.
Amazing like you, okay? Oh, Junkrat! Junkrat, get junk, son!
To kill you guys instead of pushing the payload while there's only two back there.
Oh my god!
Oh god!
Oh my god! This is not a great place to be right now. This is fine. This is totally fine. Oh my god, alright. I am fighting tooth and nail here. This is working very, very well.
Why not get away from me. Have one of each?
I am the one. I am the only. I'm bad. Feats.
The only tooth, the only nail.
I am the alpha. And the beta. The oh, yeah. I am the bug patch in the night, the hot fix during maintenance. I am the hero the player base needs. I will stop
the exploit game, abuse. The Genji.
That would be a great, like, nerdy hero name. Fucking bug fixer. No, actually, it doesn't sound too great now that
no,
I say
I think
it
that
loud.
Would be Sombra.
Oh, you could be called the Patch. That's kind of a good hero name, right? Behold the Patch.
Kinda.
And then his arch villain could be the Exploiter. I would totally watch the tales of the Patch versus the Exploiter. Like, come on. That's amazing. We need to go into comics, everyone. We need to abandon science.
We do.
And we need to go
and
into
then we
comics.
Can have the Korean rear offensive as our main story.
Yeah, we can have, oh my god, the Patch versus the Exploiter in the Korean rear offensive.
No!
We've done it! All right, comments, we need a storyboard. We need to know what's going to happen when.
Is there going to be a League of Legends tournament? Who knows?
There might be. A bit of StarCraft in there. It's anything. Yeah. Anybody's
don't forget
game.
Counter-Strike.
No.
All right, calm.
No.
Oh, the Dino will be the heroes, all right? When everybody else is dead.
Wait for everyone to die. Yeah,
everyone else will die.
I only have 100 health.
Yeah, that's fine. Everyone else will die. We will swoop.
Shred just killed everyone.
Shred! Stop! We right, are supposed to be the heroes!
I'm a hero. I got a kill.
You know... I am unamused about this. Oh,
hey,
how are you asleep?
Yay. No! Hi, Shred.
Hi, I saved you.
No,
I did.
Well, I guess the Korean rear offensive was a resounding success, and here we have Venno steal my play of the game. You ready? You ready? Look, mine just exploded on the point, killed absolutely no one, and then he gets 3 kills. It's just...
Oh, it's
really,
easy, you know?
Really quite tilting, if I'm honest with you. Thank you very much for playing, everyone. Like, if you enjoyed this, let us know what hero you'd like maximified next time. And
Soldier.
We will see you soon. A good D.Va.
Good D.Va.
D.Va.
Wiki
bye.
I've seen you get
hit like
there
five
there
goes my times. Life.
Yeah.
Oh! Oh! Nah! It's so hard! Doing well. Doing well. Oh, shit.
You're not doing
Oh, I'm doing well. Doing well.
You need to gain some forward ground.
Oh, my God. All right, I'm going to get there. No.
Oh, my God.
That's so cool. Here we go.
Come on.
There
goes my life.
Five times. Yeah.
Oh, no. It's so. All right. I'm going. Ow. The mech is too fucking big!
Damn it.
Oh my god!
Try and shoot me down with rockets.
Are
you ready?
No! Okay.
Alright, maybe.
Begin Operation Korean Girl Delivered to Hollywood.
Good name.
Go!
I feel like how one just got knocked back so hard.
Go! Oh, I refuse!
Oh, one's about to go through.
I refuse!
No!
No! Go, Korean! God, no! Mating ritual
that
just ended really wrong. What?
Yeah. Charge the thing. Good job.
I would love.
Prepare yourselves, fellow Korean girls. We've been through hell and back. Our fingers are sore from our massive APM. But we can put in one more final effort. Here the enemy comes. Prepare for battle. Begin. Fire. Work your fingers to the bone, ladies.
What the hell is going on there?
What the fuck is that? I feel like if I step
in
there, my world is gonna end.